Hey folks, Mike here from Ali, and in this video, I want to tell you all about the Global Styles interface, where we can easily customize the design of our WordPress websites with a block theme like Ali. So one of the first things many people want to do when they set up a new WordPress website is to customize the theme. Some folks just want to change the font, and others want to tweak all of the styles to match their existing brand. Now we can do all of that visually with the Global Styles interface. In traditional WordPress themes, this level of customization was a bit of a hassle because much of the theme customization happened in the code. But now we have block themes, which are built from the ground up with customization in mind. Block themes are made of entirely of content blocks, so they're easy to customize and configure right inside the native WordPress site editor. Each block theme ships with a file called theme.json, and this file defines all of the styles of the site, like typography, colors, color palettes, layout settings, and all that good stuff. And this effectively acts as a design system for your site. Now, all of the style settings in your theme.json file are fully editable via the Global Styles interface. And using the controls in Global Styles, you can easily make changes to your site's typography, colors, layout, etc. So let's hop into WordPress and check out how the Global Styles interface actually works. Okay, so in order to see the Global Styles interface, we need a block theme. So I'm going to be using Ali, obviously, and you can get that at aliwp.com, download it for free, install it, and we should be good to go. So let's hop over to the WordPress admin. And once you activate a block theme, you'll notice a new option here called Editor under Appearance. And so if we click that, this is the site editor interface. You're going to be seeing a lot more of this in WordPress. I'll actually be doing a whole video about that, so we'll link that for you. But this is effectively where you're going to build and customize your site and all of the elements needed to build a site. So we're going to focus on the Global Styles interface on this. So what I'm going to do is click into the canvas here, and you can see it kind of opens up the site editor. And I'm going to go up here and click this little styles icon here, and we get a new sidebar. So this is effectively where we're going to control all of the style settings on a block theme. So just at a very high level, let's go ahead and click this browse styles button. And what this is going to show us is all of the style variations that our theme ships with. So Ali ships with several color palettes, as you can see here. And effectively what that does when you click this, let's say you click a green, you can see not only does it change the accent color to a nice green color, but the really subtle grays turn into subtle greens. Similarly with the orange, you can see. So it's not just changing an accent color, it's actually changing kind of the whole palette of the site. And this is really helpful. So if you have, say your branding color is pink, well, instead of having to go through your new site and change every color to kind of get all the pink hues that you want and kind of fine tune everything, you can just start with one of these color palettes and then change your accent color to your brand color. And then you have like a beautiful design system ready to go. You don't have to tweak every single color. You can really get a huge head start just right out of the box. So let's go ahead and keep this pink because I want to use it to demonstrate a few different things here. So that is the style variations. And now we click back and we can see that we've made a very big change throughout our site. So this is not just on the homepage. All the places where these buttons are used are now going to be pink. Similarly, with these gray backgrounds, there's going to be a light pink. So we've just with one click, we've kind of propagated some changes very far and wide throughout our site, but we can go deeper on this. So let's click into typography. And you know, one of the things that almost everyone wants to do right away is change the font. So that we can do very easily. Let's just go ahead and hop into the headings. And you can see here we have some font options. So I'm going to click monospaced. You can see just like that, we've changed the font on all of our headings on the site very quickly. This is not the best example of a font that you would want to use, but just what's in here by default to show you how easy it is to do. And we can go further and change the font weight and line height and all of that stuff. Now we can, instead of changing it for all headings, maybe we just want to change this H1. So we can do that too. We can just change the H1 And you notice that it changes here, but all of our other headings are exactly as we left them. So let's go ahead and change that back and also make these the monospace font. And we'll go with that for now. Okay, so that is that. Now, what's one of the other things we all want to change right away is like the buttons and button colors. And so if we back up out of here and go into the colors tab, you can see that WordPress automatically pulls out the things that you're going to most likely want to change colors for. So we have text, background, link colors, button, etc. And if we dive down into something like button, we can see how easy it is to customize our button colors further. So we can kind of, you can see it's changing here live, and we can even throw a gradient on there if we want. And let's go with that just for sake of being able to see we've made some changes. And just like that, again, this is you know, something that was very kind of tricky to do in WordPress. Now we can do very quickly and easily. And so we've changed a few of those things. So let's go ahead and save that because I want to show you something else now. I'm going to refresh this. And when it loads here, I'm going to click that again. And I'm going to click this revisions tab. And you can see it says revision history 4. And what this is doing is showing us a revision history of all of the style changes we've just made on the site. So say we made some changes, but we're not really thrilled with them. We want to kind of dial them back a little bit. Maybe we don't like that gradient color on the buttons. Now I can click through and go back in time effectively and change these settings back to what they were. And if I don't like any of them, say I want to go back to the default style of the theme, I can do that and just go reset to defaults and save, and then that will blast all of the changes that I made to the site. One other thing I want to show real quick is something called Stylebook. So, you know, we have a nice homepage here and it has a lot of different elements on it. So it's easy to see all of the different elements while we're styling them. But if you have like a blog page for your homepage, you might not have as many elements. So they have something called the Stylebook. And if you click that, this is kind of like a almost like a mini website of sorts where you can see all kinds of different elements. We have all our headings lined up and paragraphs. And this makes it really easy when you are customizing headings, for example, where you can just see how the font is going to impact the style of all the headings when you have them together. So you can see the hierarchy and know that if you need to make changes to the font weight or the line height, etc. So the style book is kind of like a visual way of changing styles and seeing how the things affect the elements. So again, you can see the different buttons and how groups work and all of these different things, how, you know, style the widgets and the different things like navigation, etc. So it's just a really clean way of having an overview of all of the elements on your site. So that is really helpful. And then finally, I want to just show that you can also, you know, we can make kind of sweeping changes with these settings up here, but you can also dive down to each individual block and make custom changes to that. So if you click into here, you can see that each block comes with all of these settings, and we can change the default settings on these. So every time, say if we change the font and everything, every time we pull that block up in our site, it's going to start with these default settings. So that's really helpful if you want to change the default look of blocks, or just maybe you don't want to make sweeping changes to headings and things like that. You just want to make changes on a specific block per block basis. It's a really easy way to dive in and make those changes. So I think that's it for the global style. So you think of this kind of like as the control panel for all of the styles on your site, being able to hop in here and visually change things almost as if you had like a page builder plugin installed, but now this is just default WordPress. This comes built into WordPress if you have the right theme, something like Ollie. And you can activate all this stuff right inside WordPress. So yeah, I encourage you to hop in there and check out Global Styles. Super powerful, and it's only going to get more powerful as we go on here. So yeah, please go ahead and check that out and check out oliwp.com, download the theme. There's going to be more video tutorials like this. And yeah, so that's all I have for this video. Thanks for hanging out for a bit, and we'll see you next time.